This is Jana Gajjar, Assistant Professor at ITICT Department of LJ Institute of Engineering and Technology. Welcome to the first lecture of Unit 8. Unit 8 is about software maintenance and configuration management. So, till Unit 7, we have learned about various phases of SDLC lifecycle, in which we have learned about what is software requirement, how to define software requirement, means software requirement specification. Then in Unit 5, we have learned about a designing, okay, so user interface. Then in Unit 6, we have learned about testing and implementation. And in Unit 7, we have learned about some quality standards. Okay, so now this particular unit is based on software maintenance and configuration management. Means if you have developed any software and if you deliver that particular product to the customer, so what is the meaning of maintenance? So maintenance is basically a thing that means you are checking for your product after delivery to the customer. Okay, so in this unit we will learn about what is software maintenance, what are the types of maintenance, and about SCM, that is software configuration management. Okay, and about software configuration management process. So let's start with the outline. In this particular unit we will learn about software maintenance types, then re-engineering concept, in which we will learn about forward and reverse engineering, then SCM processes. Okay, so let's start with the first topic of today's lecture, that is software maintenance. Okay, so what do you mean by software maintenance? So software maintenance is an activity in which program is modified after it has been put into use. Okay, as we have already discussed that if you have done with your development process and you are delivering your product to the customer, so software maintenance means it is a kind of activity in which you are modifying your product after delivery to the customer. Okay, so if your product is delivered to customer and customer will give you some suggestions or feedback, then if you are modifying such kind of requirements, then it is a process of software maintenance. Okay, so software maintenance is widely accepted part of SDLC nowadays. Okay, so nowadays if you are developing any software, then you have to adapt to any user requirement that comes after delivery of that product to the customer. Okay, so requirements are sometimes uncertain. Okay, so customer demands something else after developing of that particular product. Okay, so as a developer you have to adapt that requirement and you have to modify your source code. Okay, so software maintenance is widely accepted part of SDLC nowadays. It stands for all the modification and updation done after the delivery of the software product. Okay, for an example, after 15 or 20 days you are updating your mobile application. Okay, for an example, WhatsApp. Okay, so after 15 or 20 days they will release some new modification. Okay, so new components are added, so you are updating your mobile application, that is WhatsApp. Okay, so in software maintenance what you are doing, you are modifying or you are updating the content after it is delivered to the customer. Okay, as we have already know that all these Facebook application, WhatsApp and all the mobile application are already delivered to the customer, means they are in a use, but based on the market demand and based on some issues, the developer team will update their component and source code. That is a part of software maintenance. Okay, so in software maintenance usually it is not preferred to apply major software changes to system architecture. Okay, so if WhatsApp application will give you some update, means all the existing parts are already there, but some new features or some new ways are initiated. Okay, so in software maintenance usually it is not preferred to apply major software changes to the system architecture. Okay, and maintenance is a process in which changes are implemented by either modifying the existing system's architecture or by adding a new component to the system. Okay, so maintenance is a kind of process, okay, in which you are just changing in an existing system or you are adding some new component to the existing system. Okay, let's take an example of WhatsApp. Okay, again in WhatsApp, once that particular WhatsApp is came earlier days, so it only have a chat facility. Okay, then after they have added video call and audio call facility, then a status facility. Okay, so many new features are coming nowadays. Okay, so maintenance is a kind of process in which changes are implemented by either modifying the existing system architecture or by adding some new component. Okay, so if you are updating some feature or you are adding some new feature, then it is known as a software maintenance. Okay, so this is about the software maintenance. Now let's discuss about what is the need for software maintenance. Okay, why we need to update any software. Okay, so the software maintenance is essential because of some reasons. So reasons are like, usually the system requirements are changing, and to meet this requirement, some changes are incorporated in the system. Okay, so as I have already told you that if you have developed any software and you have delivered that software to the customer, so then based on the market demand, customer will give you some new requirement. Okay, so we need software maintenance. Usually the system requirement are changed. Okay, so if customer change their requirement, then you need to modify that particular software or you need to add some features in that particular software. Okay, so usually the system requirements are changing, and meet this requirement, some changes are incorporated in the system. Then another reason is like, there is a strong relationship between system and its environment. Okay, so when a system is installed in an environment, it changes that environment. Okay, so as you already know that there is a WhatsApp application, Facebook application, Instagram, and many more gaming application are there. Okay, but mobile devices are of the different screen resolution, different operating system. Okay, so whether that particular system is compatible with all the operating system or not. Okay, so here mainly a strong relationship between particular system and the environment is there. Okay, so when a system is installed in one environment, then it will change that environment scenario. Okay, so this is another reason why we need a software maintenance. And the another reason is like, the maintained system remains useful in their working environment. Okay, so let's take an example of any software or any application that don't have any update as per the market needs. So what customer will do? Customer will remove or uninstall that particular application from their mobile devices. Okay, so software maintenance is necessary to maintain system remain useful. Okay, so if you want that your software or your application will constantly in use by the customer, then you need to improve your application day by day. Okay, so as some new feature are coming or as some market demands are arise, so as per the market demand and as per the requirement, you need to modify your product. Okay, so this is another reason why software maintenance is needed. Okay, so software maintenance must be performed in order to achieve correct faults. Okay, so by performing software maintenance, you can easily track correct faults, then you can improve the design, then implement enhancement, interface with other system, accommodate programs so that different hardware, software, system feature and telecommunication facilities can be used, then migrate legacy software and retired software. Okay, so if you are doing such thing in software maintenance, then you can easily perform this all the things. Okay, so correct faults means if there is any error or any bug in your software product, then by applying software maintenance, you can easily track for that particular fault. Okay, then improve in the design and implementation enhancement. Okay, that means if you have developed your system in a C programming language and then customer demands something else language for the better communication. Okay, so here also software maintenance will work. Okay, and it also accommodate programs so that different hardware, software, system features and telecommunication facilities can be used. Okay, and for an example, let's understand it by Facebook and WhatsApp application. Okay, so if you upload something in Instagram or WhatsApp, then it will also give you option like do you want to upload this particular status or this particular image to the Facebook. Okay, so they are integrating some application. Okay, so here interface with other system, then migrate legacy software and retire software. Means if any software or any application that is no longer used, then you have to retire that particular software. Okay, so by using software maintenance, you can easily track all these things. Okay, so this is about what is the need for software maintenance. Now let's understand about what are the types of software maintenance. So in a software maintenance, in a software lifetime, types of maintenance may vary based on its nature. Okay, so what kind of maintenance you need in your software product, that is completely based on the nature of your work product. Okay, so it may be just a routine maintenance task as some bug discovered by some user, or it may be a large event in itself based on the maintenance size or nature. Okay, so if you are working in any mega factories like any car manufacturing company, okay, so maintenance is about whole day maintenance, like you have to refill some oil in that particular machine and all. Okay, and if you are working on any IT sector, then maintenance means you are day by day reporting about the bugs and errors that user can found. Okay, so it may be just a routine maintenance task as some bug discovered by some user, or it may be a large event in itself based on maintenance size or nature. Okay, so there are some types of maintenance based on their characteristics. So types are like corrective maintenance, adaptive maintenance, perfective maintenance, and preventive maintenance. Okay, so let's discuss all the types of software maintenance in a detail. Okay, so first is corrective maintenance. Okay, so what do you mean by corrective maintenance? So these include modification and updations done in order to correct or fix a problem which are either discovered by the user or concluded by user error report. Okay, corrective means you are correcting something. Okay, so if I am using your work product, okay, and I found some error, then I will report it or I will discover that particular error. Okay, so these include modification and updation done in order to correct or fix problem. Okay, so if I found some error, then as a developer, you are fixing that error. Okay, or you are correcting them. Okay, so this is known as a corrective maintenance. Then next is a adaptive maintenance. So in adaptive maintenance, this include modification and updations applied to keep the software product up to date and tuned to the ever-changing world of technology and business environment. Okay, so as we have already discussed, if you have developed your software in a C language and nowadays a market needs something like any Python language code, so you are modifying and you are adapting that market demand and you are updating your software according to it. Okay, so these include modification and updation applied to keep the software product up to date. Okay, and tuned to the ever changing world of technology. Okay, so if technology changes, then you have to change your work product. Okay, so that is the adaptive maintenance, means you are adapting a new technology for your software product. Okay, then the next type is about perfective maintenance. So perfective maintenance means this include modification and updations done in order to keep the software usable over long period of time. Okay, so if you have developed some software, then what is your aim? That particular software will useful in a longer period of time. Okay, so it includes new feature, new user requirement, or refining the software and improve its reliability and performance. Okay, so in perfective maintenance, what you are doing, you are including some new features, some new user requirement. Okay, so your software product will be useful for a longer period of time. Okay, so same as example, WhatsApp application, they have just chat facility in early stages, but then as per the market demand, they have added some features like calling, audio call, then video call and status. Okay, so this is about the perfect maintenance. Okay, so for longer period of time, you are adding some new feature, you are adding some new requirements, and you are refining the software to improve reliability and performance in a perfective maintenance. And the last type is about preventive maintenance. Okay, so prevention means you are checking for the future use. Okay, so this include modification and updation to prevent your product from the future problem of the software. Okay, so it aims to attend problems which are not significant at this moment but may cause serious issues in the future. Okay, so prevention means you are preventing your software from the future errors, okay, or future issues. So these are the types of software maintainer. Now let's understand about the topic, that is re-engineering. Okay, so you already heard about the particular topic name, that is re-engineering, means you are engineering something in a new way. Okay, so when we need to update the software to keep it to the current market without impacting its functionality, it is called software re-engineering. Okay, so here what is happening, if you have developed any software product and to keep it in the current market you are updating your software product, okay, so without impacting its features and functionality, you are just updating your software product, okay, so that is known as a software re-engineering. Okay, so if you are using WhatsApp application and if you don't update your application for a longer period of time, you can use that particular application, okay, so without affecting actual features and function, you are updating that particular system. Okay, so that is about the re-engineering concept. Okay, so it is a thorough process where the design of software is changed and program are rewritten. Okay, so legacy software cannot keep tuning with the latest technology available in the market. So as the hardware become obsolete, updating of software become a headache. Okay, so if you are updating your performance of your CPU, means you are updating a RAM like 8 GB RAM and your system is now about 64-bit operating system. Okay, so there is a headache of software updation. Okay, so as the hardware become obsolete, updating of software become a headache, and even if software grows old with time, its functionality does not. Okay, for an example, initially Unix was developed in assembly language. Okay, as we already know that Unix operating system are written in a assembly language. Okay, when language C came into existence, then Unix was re-engineered in a C language. Okay, so because working in a assembly language is very difficult, so they will update the Unix operating system in a C language. Okay, so what you are doing, you are re-engineering that particular operating system. Okay, so without affecting that feature, actual features and function, you are just modifying the source code. Okay, so that is the concept of re-engineering process. Okay, so other than this, sometimes programmer notice that few parts of software need more maintenance than other, and they also need re-engineering. Okay, that means if you found some error in a WhatsApp video calling, then what a developer will do, developer will just remodify the code of video call facility. Okay, so other than this, sometimes programmer notice that some parts of software need more maintenance than other, and they also need re-engineering. Okay, so this is about the re-engineering concept, in which you are just modifying your software product without affecting the actual features and function. Now let's discuss about re-engineering process. Okay, so here you can see that there is a reverse engineering and forward engineering. Okay, so if you have an existing system and if you are modifying the existing system, then it is a reverse engineering. Okay, so what you are doing, SDLC phases are like requirement specification, then analysis, then design, coding, implementation and maintenance. Okay, but in reverse engineering, what you are doing, you are tracking from the back side. Okay, so first you are checking for actual code. Okay, then after you move to the implementation, then design and then specification. Okay, so reverse engineering is a kind of a reverse process of SDLC. Okay, and forward engineering means if you have done with reverse engineering, then you are adding some new feature. So in output of reverse engineering will become input for the forward engineering. Okay, so let's understand with the proper process of re-engineering. Okay, so re-engineering process will decide what to re-engineer. Okay, so by using that re-engineering process, you are able to analyze what particular feature have to be re-engineered. Okay, so decide what to re-engineer. Is it whole software or a part of it? Okay, so you need to update whole software or you just need to update the smaller or component of any software product. Okay, then it perform reverse engineering in order to obtain specification of existing software. Okay, so you already have that particular application. Now to develop any other application, you need to analyze that particular application. Okay, so that you are already doing in your project work. Okay, so existing system is there and you have to develop a new system. So what you will do, you will analyze the existing system and then after you will add some feature to the new system. Okay, so it performs reverse engineering in order to obtain specification of existing software. Then restructure program if required. Okay, for an example, if any changing function oriented program into the object oriented program. Okay, so you are restructuring your program. Then restructure data as required. Okay, so if is there any changes required in a data or not. Okay, so if any changes required, then you are restructuring the data. And apply forward engineering concept in order to get re-engineered software. Okay, so to perform re-engineering, what you are doing, you are just checking for the existing system by using a reverse engineering concept. Then you are restructuring it and you are now doing forward engineering. Okay, so output of forward engineering process is your re-engineered product, okay, or re-engineered software. Okay, so this is about the re-engineering process in which existing software is there. You are applying reverse engineering on the existing software, then you are restructuring that particular software, then performing forward engineering, and at last you will get a re-engineered software. Okay, so let's discuss about reverse engineering. So it is a process to achieve system specification by thoroughly analyze understanding the existing system. Okay, so if you learn about something existing, then you will easily achieve what to perform new in that particular system. Okay, so this process can be seen as reverse SDLC model. Okay, so that means we try to get higher abstraction level by analyzing the lower abstraction level. Okay, and an existing system is a previously implemented design about which we know nothing, and designers then do reverse engineering by looking at the code and try to get the design. Okay, so based on the code, they will try to recover the design of that particular software product. Okay, so with the design in hand, they try to conclude the specification. Okay, so it obviously a reverse process. Okay, in SDLC, what you are doing, you are just defining specification, then you are doing design and then coding. But in reverse engineering, what you are doing, you are looking at the code and try to get design. And with the design in hand, you are trying to conclude the specification. So thus, going in a reverse from code to the system specification. Okay, so in figure, you can see that existing software, you are applying reverse engineering and you will get program specification. So this is about the reverse engineering. Now, let's discuss about forward engineering. So forward engineering is a process of obtaining desired software from the specification in hand, which were brought down by means of reverse engineering. Okay, so as I have already told you that output of reverse engineering will become an input for the forward engineering process. Okay, so it assumed that there was some software engineering already done in the past, and forward engineering is the same as a software engineering process with only one difference. It is carried out always after reverse engineering. Okay, so in image you can see that there is a program specification from reverse engineering. This output of reverse engineering, it will become input for forward engineering, and then you will achieve a re-engineered software. Okay, so this is about the actual re-engineered process. Okay, so that's all for the today's lecture. In today's lecture, we have learned about what is software maintenance, why it needed to maintain your software, and about a concept of re-engineering, in which we have discussed about reverse engineering and forward engineering. So that's all for the today's lecture. Thank you.